Jump lists in Vim are a way to keep track of where you've been and allow you to easily jump back to previous locations. Vim maintains two jump lists, the normal jump list and the chain jump list. The normal jump list tracks cursor movements, while the chain jump list tracks changes. Knowing how to use jump lists is important because it can help you navigate your code more efficiently. By jumping back and forth between locations in your codebase, you can quickly reference important information and avoid having to manually scroll through your files. The two most important commands you need to know are Ctrl-O to move back and Ctrl-I to move forward. As for the rest, let's get into it. When making certain movements in Vim, such as moving between lines, we expect the movements to be part of a jump list. However, not every motion is actually saved. So I'm going to line 20 and then to line 40, and then I will move 10 rows up or down to show you whether that's saved or not. To see the jump list, we just open semicolon and jumps, and we can see the entire list from the beginning till the end. I go to the end of it, and none of these are part of the jump list. I can confirm that by tapping Ctrl-O, that takes me to the top of the document. If I use 42G or 44G, and then I go again to the jump list, I'm expecting to actually see this now part of it. And as you can see, line 44 and line 42 are part of this list now. This helps us if we want to navigate through the list using Ctrl-O and Ctrl-I, which we've discussed. We need to use G to move between lines. So that's just something to take into consideration. Let's use Ctrl-O to actualize the jump list and go back to line 44, then 42, then 50. And this way I can go back and forth. Back is Ctrl-O and forward is Ctrl-I. As mentioned in the intro, jump lists work across the project, meaning it can jump between files. So if you look down below at my buffers list, which by the way, you can check my video on buffers up here to the right, you can see that while going back in the jump list and forward, I'm jumping between different files. This is also easy to see in the jump list itself, where you can see the actual file that we're jumping to and the line that was saved. If you've watched other videos of mine, you know how much I love Telescope. So using Telescope to view the jump list can actually show you the lines themselves, including the file's preview. Another type of motion that's not included in the jump list are the one-line movements AJKL. And that makes some sense. If you think about it, you don't want every line movement to be included in a list that's supposed to help you jump across the project. And so another look at the jump list can show us that the big movements were saved and small line motions were not included. But again, if you want to be included in the jump list, you can use the line number NG to force them into the jump list. Let's take a look at some examples that do make changes to the jump list, and maybe you'd rather use them when thinking about lateral movement inside the project rather than using small motions that don't get included. The first would be the search command. So if I'm looking for the to-do word and then going next, next, next to all the results, if I go to the jump list, you can see all the results are inserted to the jump list, so I can move back and forth between them also using the jump list, or of course using N and capital N to run between different results of my search. This is relevant to both type of searches, forward with slash or backward with question mark. That works just the same. Another type of command is the percent command that can take you between closing and opening brackets. That's really useful to jump between pairs of different characters. And if I do that and going back and forth and open the jump list, I can see how both brackets appear in the results. By the way, for the scrolling feature, you can see in yellow, I'm using Tmux. If you want to know how to use Tmux better for your workflow, I suggest you take a look at the video up here to the right. One thing to note, which can be a bit baffling to begin with, you'll notice that your last point that you were will not appear in the jump list, and that's because the jump list is moving backward. But the point I'm currently at will not be listed there because it's not part of the history. Jump lists can get long, and it's actually hard to find something if you are trying. So with clear jumps, you can completely scratch out the list so that it's clean and easy to search in. I must be honest, I almost never do that, only when I want to present stuff or teach people about jump lists, but useful to know that it's out there and it's an option. As always, I really suggest you open the help for jump list. You can find out all about Ctrl-O, Ctrl-I, other explanations about how the list is organized, what important things you need to look at. One of them, for example, is the keep jumps command that helps you ignore future actions from being stored in the jump list. That can be very useful in case you want to make some changes but not store them, so you can jump back. One cool trick to force certain moves or locations to be inserted into the jump list is the use of marks. If you don't know what marks are, with the use of M and a certain register, you can save a location in the file. So I've saved MB, and then I can go to quote A, quote B, quote C, and whatever mark I'm saved in one of the registers can be saved as a location that I can jump back to. And when I open the jumps, you can see that they all appear in the list, which is very useful if you're unsure whether your motion is inserted or not, or skipped by Vim because of all its weird caveats. You can be sure that if you're using a mark, it's there. Up until now, we talked about jump lists, which allow us to go to previous locations saved into a certain list on Vim. But there's another list that's called change list, and I've mentioned it at the beginning, but there it is. So I'm making a little bit of a change here, and I'll add the same change at the end of the document. Now when I go to change, I can see a list of changes made to this certain file, and I can see the last two bits that I've added to the list at the bottom. G semicolon will take me back to the last change, and so on until I reach the end of the list. The opposite of that is G comma. With G comma, I can go the other direction in the list. And as with every other command in Vim, prefix the command with a number of times you want it to repeat itself. So I can go 3 times, 10 times, 4 times, and I can go either back or forth in the list of changes. The jump and change lists provide a strategic way to navigate files. With practice, they become easier to use. They act as a safety harness when working with large and unfamiliar files. Go ahead and tap the Vim playlist to keep learning secrets like this. Thank you for watching.